An important feature of DAE for BigQuery is data masking, which allows sensitive fields to be hidden from unauthorized users. This is powered through attribute-based access control that allows data access to be determined based on policies that examine attributes of the data being accessed, context of the request, and user identity. Those who do not meet the set requirements will find the fields to be masked. Let's consider the following scenario. Branch users should not be able to access or see the original values for purchase price and vendor columns in the item table. In order for us to meet this requirement, we need to create a policy that would allow non-HQ users to access the items table. On top of this basic policy definition, we're also going to use data masking obligation. This data masking obligation hides the sensitive data by applying a replace clause inside the SQL statement. Let's take a look at how we're going to refine this policy in the NextLabs Control Center console. Here we have the definition for allow non-HQ users access to items table. This is an allow policy for users who are not in the HQ user group, who are trying to run select statements across the items table. On top of this basic policy definition, we're also going to make use of the data masking obligation. This data masking obligation hides the purchase price from the item table using a mask -99,999. There are different options that we can select for mask formatting. We can mask the entire value, replace the entire value with a random number. We can even partial mask or key mask. Now, since we want to hide or mask two columns, we need to create an additional obligation or an additional data masking obligation within this policy. You can create more obligations by just simply clicking on the Add Another Data Masking Obligation. In the second obligation, we are masking the vendor field or the vendor column in the table using an asterisk to replace the original value. This policy has already been deployed, so let's take a look at how this will affect our policies. First, let's log in as Tony so that we will see how the original report should look like. Here in report number 4, Tony is able to see all 10 rows of the items table, and he can also see all the information like the purchase price, selling price, and vendor. Now as Linda, let's run the same report. When we run the same report, you will see that the purchase price column and the vendor column has been masked for Linda. One important thing to note when you are masking fields is that when you are running mathematical formulas against these fields, the original value of these fields will still be used. For example, let's run report 4A. In this report, we see a summary of all the items, how much the original purchase price was for each item, the recommended selling price, and how much profit you could gain if you sell this item using the selling price. If I run the same report as Linda, you will see that the purchase price is masked. However, the profit column, which is defined as the selling price minus the purchase price, is still showing the proper value. According to policy, the purchase price should be masked, which is why it is listed as -99,999. However, this does not affect the computation of the profit. With this, users are only allowed to see the fields they are intended to view. This concludes our featured demo video on data masking using DAE for BigQuery. Thank you for watching.